I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
We're talking to Mikey Garcia, the pound-for-pound king of boxing. Mikey, I've been to 3 gyms today, and everybody has been so impressed with you. Almost everyone. Todd the Buff of Top Rank just did a conference call with Lomachenko, and he said, how did he say it? That you ducked Gamboa. Why are you calling out Lomachenko? You had the opportunity to fight Crawford and Pacquiao. How do you respond to the claim that you ducked Gamboa?
Well, he's going to have to bring the Gamboa topic to try and talk me down. I'm not his fighter, so he can't speak nicely. Maybe they're still a little upset that we left, you know. But, the fight with Gamboa never happened because it only came with another extension onto my contract. And I wasn't willing to extend any terms on the contract. We were willing to fight Gamboa back then, but under separate terms, not any extensions. And he knows that. He don't have to lie. But, I mean, whatever. That's in the past. You know, I'm moving on with my career. I'm looking for big fights. We're taking big challenges. I'm not going to wait and sit around for anybody, you know?
When you read the comments, did you laugh? Did you find it like, if you were their fighter, they wouldn't be saying that, obviously.
Of course.
And you're just coming off a tremendous win.
Yeah, but he wasn't impressed. He wasn't happy. The fans are not clamoring Mikey Garcia. You know, I'm not a big name yet or something. I mean, he's not my promoter, so I understand why he wouldn't, you know, mention me. But look, if all the media keeps bringing my name up with their fighters, that should tell them something, you know? But obviously, they're not interested in fighting me with their fighters. They got their own agenda. So that's why he doesn't want to mention my name. He'd rather fight other guys and keep their fighters busy with opponents that are not relevant. Opponents that are not, you know, anything special. Opponents that are not former champions or nothing major. Just opponents just to keep them busy. You know, we're going after bigger challenges, big names that make sense. If they want it, like his, you know, his fighters, if they want it, because I know the fighter will fight anybody, but it's not the fighter that makes the call. It's the promoter and manager, and Bob Arum, Top Rank, Todd DeBuff, they're the ones handling those decisions, not the fighter. I make my own decisions. I handle my own career.
You sound That's like Floyd.
I love where I am. I love being where I am, because, you know, if certain fighters are not available, I'll go on to the next one. And they can't do that. That's why Top Rank's fighters recently are fighting just opponents, because they have nothing else to offer. And we're not. We're going after bigger fights.
So, Mikey, are you getting phone calls, text messages? Are fans hitting you up? Because I'm getting fans hitting me up, as well as media members, as well as people. Like, I guess it's a big deal to criticize you because everyone else is giving you compliments.
Look. When everybody else is writing good articles, you know, great performance, good things about me, you know, you can expect a couple of haters or just the critics, not necessarily haters, but just the critic, you know. Oh, well, maybe Broner didn't show up, he didn't throw punches. Well, you know what, I didn't let him. You know, game plan was to, you know, neutralize him in every way. I didn't let him. You know, if you ask Adrian Broner why, you know, he wasn't able to throw more punch, or why wasn't he more successful, why wasn't he working the body, well, ask him those questions, you know, because I know I did my part to keep him, you know, at bay, to keep him at a distance that best fitted me. But some guys, some promoters or writers might still downplay my performance. That's all right.
You can't please everybody.
Can't please everybody, that's okay. You know, I'm doing my job. If my team and I feel that we did a good job, that's all that matters.
Absolutely. Now, if the Lomachenko fight did happen, if Gamboa fight happened, if who else, Crawford or Pacquiao happened, how does Mikey Garcia do against those 4 guys?
Well, you know what? We would definitely have a good fight with all of them, because those are all big names. Gamboa was never going to be a fight that I would have problems with. I think Gamboa would have been an easier opponent than all the other ones mentioned. But Lomachenko would be a good fight. Crawford would be a good fight. Manny Pacquiao would be a good fight. Those are a lot more competitive than the Gamboa fight. I think it'll be a great fight, but I mean, I think at this point it's not worth mentioning those names because clearly their company has other plans and gets irritated when they mention my name around their fighters.
But if I'm not mistaken, Mike, and I may be mistaken, after Lomachenko's last fight, Max Kellerman in the ring asked him, "Who do you want next?" And what name did he say?
Yeah, well, he mentioned my name. You know, when any reporter or any writer asks a fighter, you know, if they're willing to fight somebody, and the fighter's gonna say yes. But Max asked him directly if he would like to, who would he like to fight, and he mentioned my name. It was Lomachenko mentioning my name. I've never called out anybody that direct. I've only answered to reporters when they bring up certain names. But Lomachenko did mention my name directly. But we don't see him taking the steps to actually get that fight going. He's not fighting anybody at lightweight. He hasn't moved up to lightweight, where I clearly said I would meet him. I'll fight him at lightweight. He's not. And he's taking on an opponent that, I mean, really isn't a major player, you know? So I don't know. I don't know what the reason behind that opponent. Maybe they can't find anybody else. Maybe Top Rank couldn't get anybody else. I don't know. I'm not the managers. I'm not the handler. I'm not the motor. But Top Rank definitely has other plans for their fighters. And I think it's not in their best interest, or Top Rank doesn't see it their best interest to, you know, bring my name around the discussion.
A couple more and I'm done. Robert said yesterday that you and Danny Garcia, not your brother, the fighter, would be a good fight. What do you think about you and Danny?
Maybe we get that next. Maybe we get that before the end of the year. You know, see, it's good to have options.
How about
we got big names? We have, you know, champions, former champions, high profile fighters that we can choose from. I don't need to be waiting or sitting around chasing anybody either. You know, and if we can get big names, you know, that's what we're after. I'm not here to just make title defenses against nobodies or fighting just, you know, journeymen. You know, we're here to fight big challenges. Those are the fights that I want. So possibly, man, maybe we can see Garcia versus Garcia before the end of the year.
Angel versus Robert, you versus Danny, the Big G versus I don't know who else they have on that side. But, Mikey, yesterday I'm going to tell the fans something that nobody knows. You're a star. You're a superstar in boxing. Pound for pound, the top five pound for pound, no argue. You just 37 wins, 30 knockouts. You fought Broner, went to your hotel, ate cold pizza. You didn't even have time to have dinner. Packed, went straight to the airport. From the airport, straight to see a four-round fighter fight his third pro fight, a fourth pro fight.
Yep.
Spent time with fans, and you didn't take any breaks since the morning before since you woke up for your fight. Tell me, why did you do that? Why didn't you take a week off, and you didn't have to put yourself through this?
Look, you know, after the fight, it was late. We get to the hotel room. I just gotta, you know, pack, shower. There's no time to go, you know, have a night out or go have a dinner with the family. I had some leftover pizza from the day, my pre-fight meal. So, Ryu.
What's up, Ryu?
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
So I just had some leftover pizza, cold slice pizza after my fight, and some cold chicken wings that we left over, and just packed my stuff, got in the shower, and head straight to the airport. We had an early flight catch, a 5:50 a.m. flight back to LAX. Got to LAX, then we had Alejandro Guerrero from Texas. He was fighting here in Bakersfield, so he's a fighter that me and my brother have interest in. He works with my brother, and I'm trying to help him out. So I wanted to go show him support, go talk to him a little, see how he's doing. He won. He had a fourth round stoppage, so congratulations to Porkchop. I want to look after some of these guys, you know, and why not, you know, spend some time with the fans also. I had, you know, a lot of fans surrounding me there and talking and signing pictures, autographs and taking pictures with me. That's what it's about, Mikey. I appreciate that.
I've been to Bakersfield. It's very great. It's nothing out there. It's the middle of nowhere. No disrespect to people who live there, but it's an hour and 40 minutes away from LA in the other direction. It's not like it was in Riverside. They don't get a lot of stars there. This is the first boxing match that I've heard of over there in 10, 15 years. So they were going crazy. They didn't expect you to be there when they just saw you on TV 5 hours before.
Yeah, it was a nice treat. And then I seen Vargas there too. Vargas was also there, so he also congratulated me, and the fans went crazy when they saw both of us there. And you know, it's really nice. You know, like I always say, you know, it's the fans that really make me feel worthy to be, you know, called, you know, world champion and to be given that recognition. So it was great. I mean, we had a great turnout, good fights. Fans showed up. You know, it was a nice house. It was a good turnout. We finally got home late. I got home like 10:30 at night.
After being up for 28 hours or something.
Yeah. Got home late. Kids were still awake. They were waiting for me. Put the kids to bed and finally knocked out on an actual bed and knocked out nice because I was tired.
My last question: did you watch the Victor Ortiz fight?
Yeah, well, we were there.
But sometimes
we stayed for the show. I saw the fight.
What did you think?
Congratulations! He actually looked good. He looked strong. He looked strong, and he got caught with a few punches, but it didn't seem to bother him. It seemed like he had his confidence in him, so it was a good job by him.
Okay, him and Brandon. What do you say? Is that the fight? The next big match?
Why not? I think that's the fight that makes sense right now. They both had good performances, good comeback fights. Shit, get them in the ring next. Get them in the ring in the next 3 months, you know, sometime before the end of the year, get both of them in the ring, because I think if it's ever going to happen, it should happen now.
Okay.
It didn't happen back a few years ago when it was really, really hot, but right now they both had good victory, you know, comeback wins, so let them get in the ring.
Okay, to end this interview, I put a picture on my Instagram, and I said, who do you want Mikey to fight next? It has hundreds of comments. Lomachenko, 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 Crawford, 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 Pacquiao, Pacquiao, Pacquiao. And then a fan threw a curveball and said he wants to see you against Canelo. Will you ever move up to 160 and face Canelo?
Bro, I don't even weigh 160 when I'm eating, picking out on food.
So that's out of the question. What if he comes down to 140?
He can't come down to 154. You know, if he were to be able to come down to, like, you know, a weight class, like 150 possibly, but dude, he can't even make 154 no more. You know, that's just out of the question.
And someone said Anthony Joshua, but that was a joke. So, Mikey, message to your fans, you're back, you're smiling, your face is clean, the swelling's gone already?
No, I didn't have swelling, I had a little bit of a bruise here.
Yeah, that's what I mean, the bruise, it looks like it's gone.
Had a little bit of a little shining little bruise there, but no, it felt good. I'm very happy with the way things worked out in the fight. You know, we had a good game plan, good training, good camp, good corner, good instructions by my brother and my dad. So everything worked out well. Just like always, you know, I thank all the fans because if it's not for them, you know, the victories don't mean anything. You know, you can have the greatest victory, but if the fans don't see it, it never happened. It don't mean anything.
And here's the best part. You have fans, and I see them wherever I go, Mikey. Your fans are hardcore. If an executive or promoter or someone like that doesn't see the fans, it's okay, as long as you know you have those fans.
Yeah, we got fans. I see it. I feel it. You know, I get all the comments, all the messages all the time. So for that, I thank them very much. All
right, tell everyone where to follow you on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
Like always, Team Mikey Garcia on Instagram, Mikey Garcia on Twitter. So yes, you can follow me there and, you know, say hello and drop a line, and I'll try to get back to as much, you know, as many as I can. But thank you very much for all the congratulation messages and all the best wishes and best luck, you know, wishes coming into a fight, and now all the congratulations. Thank you guys very much.
My last question, Mikey, I forgot, but I wanted to ask you this. Robert said yesterday, he told me that he thinks Broner will be champion again at 40 and 47. What do you think? Do you think Broner could come back and become a champion again?
I think Adrian has plenty left in him. I don't think he's a washed up fighter like some are starting to claim. He's got skills. He's tough. He can still be champion at 40 or 47. you just couldn't beat me. You know, I was a better fighter.
There you have it, Mikey Garcia. Mikey, just end this interview. Sometimes in my videos today, you're going to hear a lot of breathing of a dog, and it's not me. I'm going to show people.
Yeah,
this is the reason right here. Can you see her?
Yeah, I see her.
Now she's behaving, but she was going crazy before every time I'm making a phone call. So there you have it. Mikey Garcia, FiusReporting.com. I'm Melissa Back reporting. Thanks, Mike. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FiusReporting.com. I'm Melissa Back reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. I'm